Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. I'm going to take you through a combination treatment today involving the new Barb 4 PDO thread. Let's go to the treatment. We've cleansed our patient already. We do another cleanse. I'm going to place a marking. What we're doing is putting the brand new Barb 4 thread. It's a total cannula thread to lift the edge of the mouth. And I wanted to show the technique of this thread. The vector is going to be different on just about everyone. I go across the fold. Some people start here. I like to go through the fold and get a straight shot to pull that up in this direction. You could add a second, you can add a third and a fourth if the patient needs it and has quite a bit of ptosis. This patient, she looks great. There's very minimal downturn, but it's going to be preventive and give her a nice look of turning. Everyone wants this area treated. This is a little lido with epi, and I'm going to put it right back where our opening is going to be with an 18 gauge. This is a 31 gauge, a little poke here, and then I hold a little bit of pressure, and I'll take that 18 gauge needle we have over there to create the opening. Make an opening with an 18, even if we're using a 23, I like the 18. It gives a nice sized opening, and it gives you the option of putting different threads through it. So a little poke here, and then just stretching the skin. New, totally blunt Barb 4. I'm gonna have the patient look a little there, wonderful. I get a straight shot, I measure it up, come in with the bevel up, okay? And then I'm gonna take a clean 4x4, and we have our hair back, we've cleansed everything, but what we're going to do is place this in a fashion that protects where the thread is. So just in this area, we have a nice straight shot. Initially, we got to get through a layer of tissue, so you might feel a little click here. Now the depth and going in one direction is important, and we want, again, a straight shot. So you can just see it traversing. I'm stabilizing with my hand. A little pop through this tissue. You can go a little bit back, but you can't bring the thread all the way back or it will be engaged. Tension the tissue, and there'll be a little pop right there. And now I want to be a little more superficial, so I push down on the cannula, traverse. You can see it traversing nicely in a nice plane. This is the area that can get a little bit sensitive, so we're careful here. Here's the fold. Some people stop here. I like to go through the fold, tension the tissue, and keep my same plane through the fold. It can be hard if the fold is deep. In this case, it's not. Our patient's a rock star. It's a little tender here, and we don't see any evidence of that through the fold. We haven't used the whole thread, but you don't need to. I feel it here. I'm going to twist to anchor the thread, pull out. Then I have my thread here. I'm going to hold it with a little bit of tension. You can see it pull. You can see these barb fours are amazing. It's grabbing beautifully. That's a lot of pull on that. I engage the thread, pulling up, and I can feel it just chugging up. Click, 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 lifting the edge. You can already see that fold is gone. So it wasn't deep to begin with, but that means you get a perfect candidate for that. Pull it here. Now, have the patient animate, smile for us. Looks perfect. You can't see the thread. I can now pull it out. If it didn't look perfect, I would adjust the thread. I would unzip it, so to speak. This is important. I want to bury the thread, just the tip of the scissors, push down, clip the thread, and the thread only, not the skin. Get rid of the thread. And now, I still engage it one more time, so you bury the edge of the thread. And then we can get rid of our marking, lift it up. You can feel it lifted up. Get the patient to smile again. And it's perfect. There's no visibility of any thread. So we'll cleanse the skin here. We're going to treat the neck region. I get a straight plane. Tilt your chin down so we can really, so we can see, there you go. So we can see where the line goes. Are you comfortable like that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we're gonna start up here and we're gonna course down this one. And these can be used with deeper lines. In this case, we wanna minimize them and we wanna prevent them from occurring, so we're supporting them. PDO sutures will be in there for about 4 to 6 months, dissolve, and then they will leave. Whatever collagen is produced will be there for up to years. It's the patient's own collagen. They get to keep it. The aging process is dynamic, so it continues. However, we can help prevent it, and this may not be need to be repeated for a long time. So these, as opposed to the barbs, we just put them in. We're going to come to the lower line here. We put them in and they're already engaged. We just bury it by pushing back on the skin and we remove them. Doing the neck, sometimes you'll get a little bruise because there's some vascularity. Sometimes like these, there's no blood involved at all. They can be very quick to do and well tolerated by the patient. Now look down again, let's see, and then come up a little bit. So I want to support this tissue because invariably when she's having dinner, she's out with somebody, she's going to look down, and I want to get those lines too. So it's not just what we see in one dimension, it's three dimensions. And we're looking ahead years. If collagen loss occurs, we're preventing that, but we're also treating what's there now. So I'm always adjusting the depth. If I see it go superficial, I'm countertractioning. If I see it go deeper, I'm flexing upwards. And it's where the tip is. So flexing down, the tip goes superficial. Flexing this way, the tip goes deeper. And then manipulating the skin each time to move the skin where we want it. And we got our last one here. This will mesh, it will create collagen, and it will help prevent the lines and take care of the ones that are in there. Structure and support.
So there's a great combination. Combination therapy is all the craze. It's how you get the best, most natural result. Join us on this YouTube channel. Leave your comments below. Also on Facebook and Instagram for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.